Welcome back to Transitions. Today we are discussing several aspects of motherhood. In our last segment, Iris and Roxanne from the Aboriginal Designers Co-op showed us how to use traditional moss bags and cradle boards, which have been an important part of Indigenous culture for many, many years. Right now, we are going to discuss coping strategies and programs available through the Women's Health Clinic. Erin Boxdale shares some ways we can help mothers who might be struggling. Can you tell me a little bit about what the Women's Health Clinic is doing for women who are expecting their first, second, or maybe third baby?
Well, we offer a range of services in reproductive health, and one of those is midwifery care. So we do offer midwifery services. So a midwife is a registered health professional that does prenatal care, cares for people during birth and for 6 weeks after the baby is born, around 6 weeks. And so that's sort of the part of our services. As well, we offer a number of different sort of community support services and community groups. So we have prenatal workshops, we have our coping with change workshops. And coping with change is a great place for parents of all sorts of children, of all kinds of children. So be there their own children, adoptive children, kids with disabilities or medical issues as well. Just to talk about what that transition to parenthood has been like for them.
So would that cost anything, or like how would somebody go about getting a referral to the clinic?
Well, all of our programs are free of charge. So if people are interested, they can check out our website at womenshealthclinic.org, or we can call the Mothers Program at 947-2422, extension 113. And you can also email register at womenshealthclinic.org.
So are ladies out there who are maybe considering becoming a mom, and maybe they don't have a spouse, and they're thinking, you know, time, the biological clock's ticking away, I think I'd like to have a baby. Do you provide any counseling or any support to women who are considering parenting alone as opposed to with a spouse?
Or? Well, we do have we have a general counseling program. The the access can be a little bit limited. There are some wait times. I mean, people can talk about all their, get some support in working through all of their life decisions through that program as well.
So tell me about some coping strategies then. I'm a mom of two, and there are in their 20s, and I went through all of the highs and lows, you know, of being a parent, and because it's not all just glossy and wonderful, there are times when you think, oh my goodness, what did I get myself into here? And I hope that really good people come out of my parenting with my spouse. So tell me about maybe some coping strategies that are good for moms.
Well, one of the things we really like to talk about is taking care of yourself. We talk a lot about, you know, you say it's like on a plane, if the oxygen mask comes down, you have to put your own oxygen mask on first before you can help anybody beside you. It really comes down to looking after your own needs, and we actually have an acronym that we use that's sort of the basis of our program, and we call it NURSE. And so the N is for nourishment. So just that one of the very basic ways we meet our needs, right, is trying to eat foods that enjoy, that we enjoy, foods that make us feel good. And then the U, we say understanding. So being understanding with yourself, having compassion for yourself and gentleness with yourself as a parent, I think, especially new parents sometimes have that thought is, are these going to be good children? And or, you know, am I going to be good as a parent? And really having compassion for yourself that this is a new job for you, this is a whole new skill set, and this is a relationship that you're building with this child that's going to last throughout your life. So being okay with, you know, you can have a bad day early on, and you know, you're gonna work it, you're going to work on it with your children and on yourself. Then the R is for rest and relaxation. I think the sleepless nights are one of those things we think about when we think about new parents. And so really trying to allow yourself to rest and relax whenever you can, even if your floor needs sweeping or something, right? Trying to put yourself first before the needs of the house sometimes.
Yes.
And then the S is for self, and sometimes people say self or spirituality. So it's just finding some of those things that make you feel like your best self, that make you feel connected to nature or your community or your spirituality. Just putting your own interests before sort of that list of that endless to-do list that seems to always be there for parents. And then our last is E for energy. So energy or exercise. So just moving your body in ways that make you feel good. Being able to fit that in your day can really bring a sense of well-being.
So I really am thinking that our viewers out there are very happy that we had you on the show. And I really am looking forward to further discussions about motherhood in the future with you. Thanks a lot, Erin, for coming in. Motherhood can be the greatest thing for some and very stressful for others. Whether the pregnancy is planned or unplanned, there are 1,001 things to do and many changes ahead. You're not alone, however. Whether you have a support system or not, there are many resources available to help mothers through this transition. I hope that you gained something from what you heard today, and that it might help you or someone else in your community. Please visit our website, where you have all information at your fingertips. Please watch us again soon. Thank you for joining us. Goodbye for now.